conference, and it was really put on my heart to come here and be as vulnerable and open as I possibly can be, so that I can convey how resiliency has become a mindset and a way of life for me in order for me to get to where I am today. Resiliency stems from the Latin word resilire, which means to recoil, to go back. But I say that resiliency is not just about going back to how you were before. Resiliency is about going through the fire, the pain, the anger, the sadness, the depression, the loneliness, and coming out of it wiser, stronger, and better. That's what I think resiliency is. You see, pain and all those negative emotions, they're a part of life, and they're always going to be there. And it's about what you do with them that matters. That's what makes the difference. And I think that if you're already in it and you're already experiencing it, why not do something with it? And I'm going to tell you how I did that in my own life, in my journey. As a child, both of my parents abandoned me. My parents today are meth addicts, homeless, and mentally ill. My mom literally walks the street 2 miles from where I live with my children. I was raised by my grandparents, and when I was a child, my grandpa, who I love very much, molested me. I married young, and for 10 years of my life, I was mentally, verbally, physically, emotionally abused. I've been betrayed, I've been lied to, I've been left all alone in the corner of life to figure it out on my own. And I'm still standing here today telling you that if I can use all of that ugliness to make me a better person, that you can too. I used to wallow in the sadness. I used to be stuck in the darkness, living in the pain, asking myself, why me? Why, God? How am I gonna get through this? How am I going to do it? Searching for answers in everybody else, pouring into everybody else's cup but my own, giving everybody everything that I had inside of me, running from the pain, running from the depression. And it wasn't until I learned to be still. To be still and give myself time to feel my emotions. Give myself time to feel sad, feel angry, feel depressed. And then get myself back up and let it go and replace that with love and forgiveness, which I can do a whole other workshop on my own, but for the sake of time, I'm gonna let that go. But you have to replace it with love and forgiveness. And you have to start asking yourself different questions. Other than why me, I started asking myself, what can I create with all of this sadness and all of this pain that will last? What can I create in this empty time and space in my life that is beautiful? And I know everybody's creation will be different, but for me, it was about using all of that as motivation and fuel to fill my mind up with different information so that I can think differently, so that I can gain new habits and rituals while these little eyes are watching me, so that I can break generational curses and patterns in my family. And I think that is beautiful. I think that is beautiful. And if I can do it, if I can use all of that pain as motivation to better myself so that I can go in the world and sprinkle hope and inspiration everywhere I go and tell people, don't give up. There is light at the end of the tunnel, but you have to use the darkness to propel you there. You have to use the darkness to get you there. There's a Latin saying, it says, per aspera, deus dura, from adversity to the stars. And take that with you wherever you go. Thank you.